Hey, I'm Tony Northup. Let's talk about customizing Photoshop. Photoshop is incredibly complex, but you can also personalize it very much to your work style. You can hide all those many, many tools that you don't need, highlight things that you use all the time, bring them to the front, add your own keyboard shortcuts, completely change the menu system. There's really no other app that allows for this kind of customizability, but we spend so much time in it, it can really be worth it. The first thing I'm going to show you is just the workspaces. Real quickly, window, workspace, and then you can pick from their default workspaces. It starts with the Essentials workspace, which has things like these color swatches here, and that's useful if you're painting, but we're photographers. So workspace, window, workspace, and then photography is where I prefer to start editing. So with that quick tip, let's go on and talk about modifying keyboard shortcuts, because there are a ton of useful keyboard shortcuts, but not every tool has its own keyboard shortcut. For example, some of my favorite tools for photography are like the Spot Healing Brush and the Healing Brush tool, and they both have the same keyboard shortcut, J. So you can hit J multiple times. You can hit J or Shift J to switch between them. So I'm hitting Shift J over and over again, and it's switching between them. But what a pain, right? Because I'll hit V to switch back to the Move tool, and then I'll hit J again. It always goes back to the tool you were last using. So if you switch to the Patch tool, it'll go back to the Patch tool. J doesn't always jump to the same tool, and that's a problem. So let's talk about how to assign it its own keyboard shortcut. Go to Edit, Keyboard Shortcuts. And Photoshop is going to show you just like a list of tools and menu items. So if you want to assign a keyboard shortcut to a menu item, you can select application menus for shortcuts here, and then scroll down and pick whatever menu item it is that you're using all the time. If you happen to use check-in a lot, you can select that and then press the keyboard shortcut you want. Maybe you want it to be, well, you can't be that. Some things are invalid shortcuts. Okay, so we can do control period, and that can be check-in. It's not a menu that I actually use. So let's assign a keyboard shortcut for that tool. So I'll select tools from this list, and then I'll scroll down to Spot Healing Brush, something I use all the time. Instead of J, let's make it Control J. No, you can only use A to Z for tool shortcuts. Right, and I forgot this, and everything is already assigned. So what we're going to do is find a keyboard shortcut that we no longer care about, and we're going to get rid of it. Like, some of these are not useful in photography. Let me just scroll through. Okay, so for example, you can hit the Z tool to zoom in, but I always just use the mouse wheel, perhaps with like the control key. Let's just delete that shortcut. We're going to use Z for our healing brush tool. I use the Spot Healing Brush tool all the time. So I'm going to select that and press Z. Now it's uniquely assigned to that. And I don't use the Patch or Content Aware tools often enough that I want a keyboard shortcut for it. If I have to use those, I'm happy going and clicking that. So now the Spot Healing Brush tool has the keyboard shortcut Z. The Healing Brush tool has the keyboard shortcut J, and it can always be like that. Now, if I hit J, it's always going to go to the Healing Brush tool. And if I hit Z, it's always going to go into the Spot Healing Brush tool. Reliably, 100% of the time, no more ambiguity. Think about how you work, the tasks that you regularly are using the mouse for, and assign as many of those tasks as possible to unique keyboard shortcuts. Only do this if you regularly work from the same computer. If you're constantly hopping on different computers, or if other people are using your computer, that can get a little confusing, and you'll get in the habit of using a keyboard shortcut that's not there, and that can really throw you off. But if you're always working at the same workstation or a couple of workstations, this can be such a big time saver. Let's talk about editing the menus. Go to Edit and then Menus down here. And this is actually the same dialog box. You can see the tabs up there. Now, you can expand a particular menu and completely change the menu system. This is a pretty amazing feature. One thing I never use Adobe Bridge. So I can just simply get rid of that. I'm just going to select it and then hit the little trash can icon here. Oh, what I can do is I'll hit the disable the visibility of it. So I'll hide that. And let's see, I never use check-in. I never use revert. I do use export, but I never do this or that or that or that or that. So there are lots of things that I just never use. And I'm just going to clear them because when you go through these menus and you're looking for a menu item, it can take you, you know, maybe it's not a full second, but maybe it's a split second while your brain is going through that menu trying to find it. And those split seconds add up into minutes, and those minutes add up into hours. Generally, anything you can do to simplify the user interface is going to make your life much better, and it'll make you a more efficient photographer. So I've hidden a lot of these menu items. I never use file info. I never use print one copy. So I'll click OK now, and we'll take a look at the file menu now. You can see it's much shorter than it used to be. If you need to use one of those menu items, they're not gone forever. Just click Show All Menu Items at the bottom of the menu. It'll appear exactly the same way for any of the menus. So what I've done on my own personal workstation is gone through and hidden all those menu items that I don't use all the time, knowing that anytime I do need to go back to one of those menu items, I just click that last menu item to show all the menu items. Another thing you can do to customize the menus is to highlight menu items in different colors. So something I use really regularly is fill here, and I want to assign a different color to it. So I'll make this red. And while I'm at it, I always use keyboard shortcuts for cut and copy. So I'm just going to get rid of all of those because I always use keyboard shortcuts for those things. So now when I go to the edit menu here, fill is actually highlighted. So now you've optimized your keyboard shortcuts, made your menus look simple and great and colorful. Let's talk about how to get those toolbars cleaned up. There are lots of tools on the toolbars I don't care about. I'm sure that's the case with you too. Edit, toolbar. And now Photoshop's going to show you all the tools on the toolbar. This is your toolbar here. It's a thing that you use all the time. First, you can click the little double arrow here to either expand it to two rows or to make it one row, whichever your preference is. Let's go back to editing the toolbar, and you can see it's showing me all the tools here, and these map to what we see over here. So these two are visually grouped together. That means that I have to hold this to make them both appear, but it won't actually let me do that while I have the dialog open, but you know how that works. I don't care about the artboard tool. I never use it. So I will just move it over here to the extra tools. Now, these four things are all grouped together. I never use a single row marquee tool or the single column tool, but I do use the elliptical tool and the rectangular marquee tool pretty regularly. So let's separate those out into separate groups. And we can see that right away that now they're both visible without me having to click and hold. I hate the click and hold thing. So what I've done with my toolbar is to go through and remove all the groups and just hide all the tools that I don't regularly use. So I really never use the polygonal or the magnetic lasso tools. I'd use both the quick selection tool and the magic wand tool. So I'm going to separate those. And for example, I don't find the slice tool useful or the perspective crop tool. It's just all about how you work. And there are all these tools on here that as a photographer, you probably never need. But they're taking up your desktop space. They're slowing you down as you work because you're looking for them. I assigned some new keyboard shortcuts to these. Okay, great. Now, you can also save this as a preset if you want to. You don't necessarily have to because you can also save this as a workspace, and I'll show you that in just a second. But you can say Tony's presets, and then you could later load it. It's just kind of specific to the toolbar. Now, there's a checkbox here for disable shortcuts for hidden toolbar extras, and you might want to clear that. For me, for example, I will always, always press the V key. I never come up and use the move tool. I've just memorized that keyboard shortcut. So I never, ever click the tool. Because I know the keyboard shortcut, I can just get rid of it and hide it. I'm always going to use the keyboard shortcut. But you just have to be sure to clear the disable shortcuts for hidden toolbars extras checkbox. So I can click done now. I would go through the rest of that. I just won't make you sit through me customizing my toolbar. But you can see life can be much easier once you get rid of those unnecessary things or tools that you use so often that you've memorized the keyboard shortcut for it. Now let's talk about workspaces. All these customized settings kind of go into your workspace as well as the arrangements of your panels. So earlier I showed you that you can select the default photography workspace here. If you make changes to it and you don't want it, go to Window Workspace and then select that workspace and then hit Reset Workspace. And that will allow you to customize it. But you can also make your own workspaces besides the ones that come with Photoshop. One thing you might want to do is to change the way these panels are arranged. For example, I always want to see my histogram. I do not want to be fighting with the adjustment panel and have them sharing a single panel. So I'm going to pull the adjustment panel out into its own separate guy and I'll drag it right there. So now it's taking up its own separate space. I also really like to see both the layers and the histories at the same time. I'm always jumping forward and backwards in my history. So I'll just dock this at the bottom there. So there, I've rearranged my panels a little bit to surface those tools that I use most frequently. The tools that you use most frequently might be different. That's the beauty of it. You can customize it to your own specific needs. But of course, you'll want to save this now. By default, it will save it for you. So the next time you open Photoshop, you'll be getting this same arrangement. But if you're switching between different arrangements, like maybe you want different tools when you edit landscapes and portraits, you can save them as workspaces. It's also good if you share a computer with somebody. So Window Workspace, and we'll call it New Workspace, and we'll call it Tony's Portraits. And then I'll have to select these checkboxes here to store the keyboard shortcuts, menus, and toolbars. And I'll click Save. So now you can see I can go to Window Workspace, Photography, and switch back to, well, it actually saved it. Let's reset the photography workspace. Now we're back at the original Photoshop photography template. Let's jump back to my workspace, Windows Workspace, and Tony's Portraits. And you can see it brought back my panels and everything else here. That's about it. It's terribly useful to customize Photoshop. You don't need to do it on day one. I wouldn't recommend doing it on day one. But once you have spent a month in Photoshop and you know the tools that you use and you don't use, it can be such a big time saver. Hope this helped. Thanks.